I didn't activate this? I didn't activate this? What? What? What the fuck? I didn't even get this! God damn it, this bit actually is going on a fucking video! God damn it! Fuck!
What the fuck was that voice?
Hey there guys, I'm BellPCC and welcome back to another episode of Banjo-Kazooie. In the last episode, we fucking fuck shit cunt fucker. That's how I feel about Rusty Bucket Bay. Anyway, in this episode, I did some stuff before starting this episode, at least I record that I did it. So, you guys will see that now. Yay! I know I've not even introduced myself yet, but this bit's getting like cropped into like a little montage-y bit. Like, I'm gonna mention it and it's probably this bit's gonna play after the intro. We almost have enough mumble tokens already for the next... Fuck's sake, game! Stop handing me out mumble tokens, you're making the game easy. Oh well, I'll see you after I've introduced the episodes. Or whenever. Oh, look at Honeycomb. See, aren't I just crazy? Now let's just go through this door and... Tentacles. This reminds me of Japanese hentai for some odd reason. Oh well. I'm just gonna be... Okay, screw you two then, I'll just... Yeah. I just did. Anyway, welcome to the area just before Click Clock Woods. Or as I like to call it sometimes, TikTok Woods. What? This is what happens when you're in a Skype call and you're playing Super Mario 64 and you're like, I should go and record TikTok Woods. Oh, wait a second. It's Click Clock. What game am I playing? Oh god, but there's been a reason I've been playing Mario 64 a lot recently, but I'm not going to go into it yet. There'll be a video about it explaining it when it happens. No, it's not my next project. I've already announced what my next project is. And when you need to come here... There's another mumble talking. And we need to come up here to actually activate the switch. And now we have the fun thing of backtracking! Yay! I went the wrong way. There's a faster way. Fuck you. I make the rules around here. What's down here? I didn't notice this. Is there like something special down here? I bet it's like a... Oh. Yeah, you see me activate the other one of these at the beginning of this episode. That's where it is. I missed out on my last playthrough of the game. Anyway, two mumble tokens I need to go and get. Wait, did I get one of them? I think I got one of them.
I can't even remember that now! What is wrong with me?
I'm gonna go and check it. Because it'll bother me otherwise. If it's not there, I'll just cut back to when I'm in this room. Okay, so there was nothing there at all.
We're gonna be one shot, aren't we? Griselda, you're a meanie.
But yeah, as you can probably guess, you don't need to get all the mumble tokens in the game to get all the mumbles. Yeah, kind of pointless in my opinion, but here it is. Click Clock Woods. Now just enjoy this music for a second because it's good.
What?
I thought the mumble token was... How did I not collect that there? Thank you. But yeah, I really like the Griselda's Click Clock Woods theme. So much, in fact, I'll probably use it as the outro to these videos. And I'm using the word these videos because Click Clock Wood is a long world. It's not hard, it's just, it's like Ocarina of Time. It's set up. It's just full of setups. That was a speedrunning joke there. No one laughed. Okay, I'll just go crank on. I don't know what it is. This game's music, especially Griselda's theme, is just so catchy. The sequel of this game's music is not as good in my opinion, but again, it's still good. I just prefer Banjo-Kazooie's music. I'm surprised I've actually not done as much singing along as I'm doing now, because this game's my childhood, basically. I don't know if I've not mentioned that already, but this game is essentially my childhood in a nutshell. This, Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask, and Super Mario 64. Banjo-Kazooie to an extent as well, but not as much as this one. So it just feels nice to be playing it again in glorious HD! There's nothing behind me? Okay. What? I'm a graphic whore. You know I'll play the better looking version of a game. Anyway, we're already in the world, even though this looks like a hub. But this world is split into four separate areas. Each area is based, as you can see already, off of each of the four seasons. That's why it's called Click Clock Woods, because we're clicking clocking the time on. So yeah, as you can see, there's spring, autumn, winter, summer. I didn't look at spring when I said spring. And we start off in spring. Now, there's also another gimmick to this world, which I really do like, but I don't want to get into it until we're at least in summer. So yeah, spring is one of the longer areas, with winter being one of the shorter ones, I think, if I remember correctly. It has been a few months that I played this for the what I'm calling the field recordings, even though they weren't failed. Now, the notes and the gingers are split across all the areas, and the notes are kind of all in the same area. Some of the gingers are the same color. Some of the gingers have the same color as the grass, so please do be careful about that. And yes, you can go invulnerable to avoid taking damage from them, but I don't like doing that. Now, there's a few things we need to do here. Like down here, you're gonna see in a second, a beaver. We cannot deal with him yet. We are in the wrong season to deal with him. So, yeah, try all you want. You cannot do solve his problem in spring. And you know the guys that come out the walls? This is their replacement in this world. The birdies. Oh god, fuck the birdies. That's all I've got to say. Now you can actually only transform into this world's transformation in spring. So make sure you have enough mumble tokens by this point. There's no setup required. Uh-oh. Somebody move this boulder. Johnny can't get in his house. I don't care. You should have lived somewhere where boulders weren't going to crash in front of your front door. Go and get the beaver removal team or something. But yeah, what I'm going to basically be doing in this world is a lot of cutting. I'll probably say this world will be quite heavy in the cutting. Because it is big, and it is long, and that is what she always says. And there's a lot of setup required. Like, spring is a very setup heavy area, so we will not be getting many jiggies in spring. But we'll be using spring to get prepared for summer and later. So just be aware of that. Now, I'm going to kill most of these things because they are obnoxious. And I do get some of these confused with each other. I'm going to just use my golden bells first for a second. God damn it. But yeah, there's a lot of... I can't stress the fact that there's a lot of setup. As in, there's a lot of setup. So, yeah. Some notes over here. Now, you'll see this patch of kind of soil thing here that just made Banjo dark when you... And I soon say, okay. What you want to do is. Okay. That's kind of awesome, actually. I was just positioned perfectly for that to happen. No! Eggies! Eggies! Okay, fuck you too then, Eggies. What you want to do is you just want to poop in here. And you want to continue to poop. Until that blooms. Guess what, guys? This is a setup! We've got to do stuff to this in each season until we can use it. As you can guess, it does die in winter, so yeah. So the last thing we need to do to it is in autumn, so yay. Ow! I suck at this game. But yeah, there's a lot of other places we still need to go. I'm going to start by climbing up the big middle mountain thing. Now, this world isn't really that big, but because the world is the exact same four times over, and it's different every time. I may get stuff confused between the seasons. So yeah, watch out for that. And that's also why it takes a while, because of the four seasons. If this was just one season, a one season world, it would not take long at all. I want to go up to the top and hit you. You're going to need a lot of invulnerability feathers in this world, and I mean a lot of them, because it is probably... No, not probably. It's just the most annoying, well, not the most annoying world of the game that belongs to Rusty fucking me! Ah! I'm gonna die! Why am I doing this voice? How the fuck do you get health? Oh yeah, there's a thing under there. I'll just cut ahead until I'm starting to actually claim, because now I'm being repetitive. I forgot the camera controls weren't varied in this game. Okay, so here are some notes. So we want the notes, and I want that. I will take the damage to get that. It's worth it. I You can see I'm already down quite a lot of health. This world is very hard on your health, so just be aware of that. You can only get up that way in summer, or you can get up in spring as well, but we're not going to be doing it in spring. We're going to be doing it in summer, because it's easier. That's just a waste to get use a feather for a feather. Oh, look, a mumble token that we can collect. You know, it means nothing. Screw it. Trading health. Trading health. Oh my god, I'm almost dead. Holy shit, holy shit, holy shit. Yeah. This world, as I've said, is not nice on your health. I think some enemies do 2 damage, so do be aware of that. Now, we're going to need red feathers. We cannot deal with what's up here just now. We can do that in summer, however. But I just came there to get the mumble talking just to show that one off. If you've been following along in this project since the beginning and playing along, God, you have a lot of patience. Because it took me so long to even just get to this point in the game. In the project. Okay, now let's see. This here. This is a bitch. I'm just going to say that right now. I hate what happens to this in later seasons. Because there are notes here in one of the seasons, and they are a bitch to get. I think they took me 10 minutes last time. I'm not exaggerating. So just... Oh, God. Fucking damn, Banjo. Oh God, I actually panicked and let go of the button too earlier. Well, I'm not dead. Yeah, watch out. You're going to take a lot of damage if you fall. Now, the reason we actually came up here is so we can come up and smash this switch to make the summer door open, which causes the game to save. Yay, auto-saving games that I do not like the auto-save function of. And then you got the squirrel. And Mumble talking to the squirrel says, Chomp, chew. Nabbit likes acorns. I'll just eat a few more. I have a feeling that's going to bite you in the ass later, but okay. Can I leave? Thank you. There's something up there, but we... Wait, where is it? There. Something up there, but we cannot deal with it until a later season, so... Sorry, guys. Also, as the seasons do pass, more enemies do appear, so... Like, here in one of the seasons that actually has enemies you gotta watch out for, so just be careful. Up here is an egg. Oh god, camera! The fuck? Can I get up here without dying? Thank you. This world just panicked me.
Bar me, Iri, mighty eagle. Need sleep now.
Oh, okay.
Stop snoring! I don't even snore.
How do you know if you snore if you're sleeping?
Well, I was actually interested to find out if I do snore or if I do speak in my sleep, so I downloaded an app for that.
There is an app for that. It records you while you sleep when you make noise. It's very interesting.
All the noise came from me just trying to move about in my bed, so... Yay. I did know I was actually like that in my bed. Why am I talking about what I'm like in bed? Oh god, fucking damn it. You guys are just gonna remix that somehow.
Actually, no you're not. There's only like 291 of you at the time of recording. And I don't think any of you are gonna remix me.
If you do remix me, I don't really care. And that's our first jiggy. Again, this is set up the world. You think I would enjoy it, but I don't. It's just because I play Ocarina of Time a lot doesn't mean I like setups.
Oh god, that's kind of intuitive, isn't it? Anyway. What else do we need to do in spring?
Oh, motherfuck! Yeah, you take a lot of damage if you fall. Holy shit.
I don't think there's anything else we need to do in spring, though, because... Yeah. Or is it summer when it's the time you can't speak to normal?
I think it's spring, because I think there's a pun, actually.
No, it's...
Wow, we have way more than enough. We had more than enough before we even... Wow. Mumble, your prices. You need to put them up to adjust with inflation. This is the last Mumble of the game, by the way. And the last transformation is... My greatest fear! Great. I am now my greatest fear.
That's nice.
But again, you can only do this in spring. You cannot do it in any other season. So you can guess for the rest of spring, we're really just going to be this obnoxious guy. And it allows us to get another jiggy that I completely actually forgot about. Thing is, These things don't hurt you in your B at least. So, yay. Now, where is the, whatchamacallit? Yes, we're now calling it a whatchamacallit. Because, whatchamacallit. God damn it, B! I wish there was like a quick way to land, like there is for Kazooie. You just press the Z button on the N64, one of the triggers on the Xbox. Just like, I want to be able to beak bomb thing into the ground, so will you let me do that, game? I just realized my recording is about 19 minutes long, but this is like only 50 minutes in the episode because I was random at the start, and I know I'm cutting it out and putting it in like something else. Bzz. Hello, fat little bee. We Zubas are guarding Grunty's golden honey piece. We've been told that there's a honey bear out there. Yeah, we can get this jiggy later. Not now. So I'm not gonna guess it just now. Instead, I'm gonna just walk out the. Thank you. I don't think there's really anything else we can do. I'm just gonna explore all, but just to make sure, because that's the one obnoxious thing is if you forget to do something in one of the seasons, you gotta go back to that season and do it in that season again. It's just like, so yeah. Again, like all other worlds, this is without a guide. Since I've done it kind of recently, I still have it in my memory. Surprise, that it's actually that good. But yeah. Also, as I was saying earlier, you can only get up here in summer. And that's why, because you need to...
Oh! You did 2 damage?!
To be honest, I'm kind of glad I died where I died, because I didn't want to... And do stuff. Basically, if you die in any other season other than spring, you've got to reset a bunch of shit back up. So, yeah, just be aware of that. And that's just an extra life. I guess I can go and get it. I'm just gonna make sure like the birdie is still activated. I think just in case he like goes back in his egg, that would be obnoxious for me because that would mean I'd have to rehatch him and stuff. That's why you don't want to die, it's just because shit like that can happen. Birdie's close. Hey, thing that's not gonna hurt me because I'm a bee. No, Birdie's awake. Not awake, alive. So, we're gonna go to summer now, so. Yeah. Summer is probably. Is it summer or autumn? Summer or autumn is the longest season. So. I know we didn't do a lot in this episode, but I think we're going to split these up a little bit better than I have been. So, next time on Banjo-Kazooie, we will go into summer. That just looks wrong. See you guys then. This is Bill PZC signing out. Goodbye, guys. I want to land on the ranch, please. Les. Les. That's not landing on the ranch! God damn it! There we go.